What's good, YouTube? It's your man's Mo back for another video. And today, man, as you can see by the thumbnail and the title, we are back again for another amazing part, chapter, whatever, to Alan Wake 2. This is chapter Masks, if I'm not mistaken. And I guess we have to talk to Mr. Door. What's his face is searching for Mr. Door. But I think Mr. Door, Scratch, Eva Ghost, Majigger, they're all the same energy presence, whatever. But let's just go ahead and let's get right into it. Is it just okay? It's in the game. I don't know why it's doing that.
I don't have time for this, so let's get it over with. Tell me, was this all fake? A show?
No one said otherwise, Mr. Wake. It was to indulge you, but we can stop pretending now.
Masks come off.
Oh, I wouldn't go that far. I don't even think you know who's under your mask, but you know how to make things difficult for yourself. All these rules, endless, convoluted loops you insist on going through. You are so lucky, you know. There are so many people helping you. Armies of people. Myself. Your wife.
Alice. I need to get to her. She's in danger.
She is.
Wrote her. I think he wrote her in a story.
What you're talking about. I have to go now.
Maybe you will make it through this time. This is enough. This and our night springs was a nice distraction.
It's time someone gave me a straight answer.
Next time we meet, the circumstances will be very different. And you would do well to return the favor by playing your part. Or stay out of my way, Mr. Wake.
Door, Zane, the masks were finally coming off. Was it a sign I was closer to escaping? I had no time to waste.
Okay, so all it says is just escape the showroom. So let me see. Can I escape through? It doesn't seem like I can exit that way. So I think I have no choice but to go to the back. Yeah.
Wake. Wake.
What door is this?
Thank you.
Force it open.
I think I have to go all the way around.
Jumalauta, that held you close, Tom. Ei muuta kuin onward, set the granny in the snow. When the panic is biggest, the help is also near.
Dor didn't seem happy to see me this time.
Fearing the master is the root of wisdom. But don't let the game get you down. He's playing his role. Maybe put him in your films, Tom, like you have put me. Sehän olisi.
Yeah, okay.
I'm a fan of your masterworks. There is Tom the Poet, my favorite, and Öden Yö is the most famous one, of course. And is it true what I hear, that it's coming back to cinemas? Is there a bottom to this rumor?
I need to get back to my apartment. Can you help me?
Well, plan is half done. You asked me to make sure you won't forget the light pictures. The photos your artist wife took. They are waiting in the shoebox in the basement. What you leave behind, you find in front of you.
Okay. Thanks, Adi. I couldn't get in. I was missing something. These were Alice's photos. I recognized the style. One showed the clicker sinking into darkness. The other showed a light in the shape of a bullet. They were important, even if I didn't know what to do with them yet.
He's going crazy in there.
To get to Parliament Tower, I needed to find a murder site. Zane would know where to find one.
There's an echo right here.
messy maze of blood trails I was chasing the cult through, I ran into the filmmaker, Thomas Zane, an esoteric bohemian with a hard-on for acts of cruelty performed in the name of occult nonsense. A director wants to control every aspect of the world in their films. Is a cult leader any different? Was Zane just another alias for Scratch? There was a rumor that Wake and Zane had been working on something together. I was gonna get the truth out of Zane with whatever means necessary.
Another echo.
Had I chosen to pursue the cult, or had they chosen me for some unknowable purpose? To be a demon, to sort the clues based on my interpretation, to change that which I observed. It was all a play. Shadows on the
I'm confused, because like anytime he's in this space, the only person that he sees in the echo is Casey.
The shadows,
but I thought Saga is supposed to be the one saving him, which is interesting.
Set up for someone else.
Hopefully, it lets me actually walk in this time.
Zane's room 665 was upstairs. The elevator would take me there. Something told me Zane wouldn't be happy to see me this time.
Why not? Oh, shoot.
I'm in control now. The second you try anything, I will shoot you in the head. Scratch wrote return, not me. You're a fucking liar.
You'd given up. You stopped writing. You said it was too dangerous, that we didn't deserve to get out. And then he showed up. Scratch. He promised to write. To get me the hell out of here. He was magnificent. A visionary. I mean, it was art. Finished. It took return and left me behind.
It's still here, and so is he.
I know I fucked up. But you can still catch him before he gets out, before he gets to your wife. And when you get to him, don't hesitate. Kill the bastard for what he did to us. There's a murder site. In my cinema, where my film Nightless Night is playing.
He just killed the dude? Oh.
I told you not to try anything!
Shh.
I had to find the movie theater Poets Cinema. The next murder site was there. Zane created the film in tandem with Return to escape the dark place. I could see the searchlight beams of the... movie theater on the far side of the plaza.
Oh, Lord. All the way down here.
The story determined where I could go.
I die like that. Fucking stupid. have to go through the car wash. Two echoes.
Something kept me going. A broken man. No hope, no prospects, no luck. Something kept me going. A broken man. No hope, no prospects, no love. Too stubborn to die. Like a cockroach with a misguided sense of honor and justice in a city where there can never be justice.
Okay. That is another echo. Oh, shit.
In his image. Just like us, he is an uncaring, cruel son of a bitch. Having made it in heaven, he doesn't want us there, dirtying up all that nice white upholstery. And he doesn't want to reach down to help us. He gets his kicks just binge-watching us struggling, hurting, killing, dying, screwing it up again and again. Lazily stirring it up when things threaten to get too placid. This city is only here to satisfy his sick, voyeuristic pleasure.
The theater appeared to be closed. Maybe the ticket could still get me in.
Please enjoy the film. Oh, wow.
The cinema lobby was a gateway to other realities on the silver screen.
I could set a scene here. I needed a new draft of the story, one that would get me ahead of script.
First off, I need a map.
Did I stop writing at some point? I can't stop. There's too much at stake.
I wonder why he... Maybe he figured out that he is Scratch, and he thought the only way that he could stop Scratch was for him to stop writing in general. Maybe. That's just my thought process at the moment. Okay, I'm moving ahead too fast. Damn, they don't got no fucking map in here. Like, what the hell?
Surface from the dark with their depraved acts of violence and fade back into the night, leaving behind bloody crime scenes and clues heavy with obscure meanings that led nowhere. Arriving at the cinema, I felt a monumental, terrifying revelation trembling before me, ready to open its jaws and swallow me whole.
This place had significance to the cult. There was something to use there.
I find it weird that I haven't found not a single map yet. Not a single map.
I needed a new draft of the story. One that would get me ahead.
Yep, here go that weird shit.
First step toward the murder site. I was making progress. Someone had barricaded themselves in the room. Missing something. I needed a new draft of the story, one that would get me ahead of Scratch.
Buddy.
It was an initiation ceremony, or so we made our new members believe. Two of New York's finest. They had performed endless favors to earn their place among us. We had something special waiting for them, and something very special for you, Alex Casey.
Who's your leader?
I thought you said it was gonna take 3 hours.
You will meet him soon enough.
There was no end to the corruption. It fit the genre, so I'd use it.
Congratulations.
I'll get you later.
Oh, I can't move. I was about to say,
you was scared?
Yeah, if I can't move my character, Jesus. Okay, this area was circled though. Is this circle because of the word upstairs? Word affix, okay. Increase maximum health by 15%. Increase maximum health restored in safe haven by 30%. Restore of maximum health when a new word of power is discovered. investigate. Paul. Okay. Investigate theater hall. Where's the theater hall? That's what it said. Investigate the theater hall. Okay, I'm in the lobby here. Where is theater hall? Unless this is the hall. Somehow this takes me over here into the projection room. Screen, pop, prop, storage, garage, back lot, central area, spotlight. Okay. So I guess this is theater hall. Oh, okay. So this is the theater hall. Yeah, give me 1 second. Yeah, I'm coming. That was wild. I definitely hear an echo though. I don't know. Oh, it's right there. Okay, so I gotta get on the stage.
The urban legends circling Thomas Zane were a bottomless rabbit hole. I'd done some digging. To film freaks, he was a mythic auteur in the art house cinema. A rising star coming to America from Finland. But he only created one film, Tom the Poet, before he went missing, mirroring the vanishing of the main character in the movie, played by himself. The biggest mystery was around his lost film, an early work made in Finland, Nightless Night, rumored to have mystic properties. Some claimed it was a snuff film, that the ritual murder in the film was an actual murder. There were no known surviving copies, but the cult chased it as if it were their unholy grail, just like Wake's books were.
Sad bunch of clowns in funny masks and hoods pretending to be a secret society.
Well, maybe it is you who's playing a role, Mr. Casey. A role carefully laid out for you. A puppet blindly performing the ritual steps for the glory of the cult. Huh?
What the fuck have you been smoking?
Nightless night. A clip of the lost film survived. You will see, Mr. Casey. In the Nightless Night, you will finally see.
Nightless Night was Zane's film. It played a role in this story.
Find a way into the projector. Find a way into the projector room. Watch the fragment. Okay. Okay. We're gonna do that. Hold on.
What is this?
Is it playing me this way? Zane's lamp on the screen had no light. I could transfer the light in my lamp to his. Screen and revealed the door.
So this door is supposed to, I guess, lead me upstairs.
I was back out into the night. The seedy alley away from prying eyes was a good scene for dark deeds.
Wait, what? Wait. No.
Someone had fallen to their death from the rooftop. I need to find the answer on the plot board.
I feel like I went a direction I wasn't trying to go.
Police car felt important to the story. The answer was close. For this initiation, do you?
Nah, I'm sure we'll just chance.
Yeah, these cops stay hiding and fucking messing up these fucking scenes and shit.
Made plenty of their problems disappear. Dumped all those nobodies down that chute.
What we did or didn't do, it's all behind us now. We're going straight to the top, partner.
Yep, like we died and went to heaven.
Down the chute. Okay, but there was still, there was an echo as the world of the cult. That echo is still right there.
city trapped in eternal night. They watch the film where the night never arrives, where the night hides in your mind.
This door is locked.
Straight to the top. The dirty cops looked down at the city. Their city. They had committed repulsive deeds to get there. They told themselves it was worth it.
got me, Mr. Casey. I'm all yours. Go ahead. Ask that burning question in your mind.
How did you do it? How did you get me into that film clip without my remembering it? Talk to me, damn it!
You've seen the film? Good, good. Now you're ready to meet the Grandmaster. He's waiting for you in the projection booth where everything will be revealed, where he will project a new reality onto this one. And now, Mr. Casey, I've played my part to the end.
No, no, no! Crazy bastard!
He jumped off.
Why'd he jump?
The projection booth. Was that where I find the murder site?
Okay, let me try to process this a little bit. This. These stairs here are gonna bring me to the projection room for me to get into these stairs. But I thought I took those stairs, but I guess not. Oh, because it's opposite. It would have been the other side. Okay. So now let me check spotlight and figure this out. Speedy ones, because they're speedy for no fucking reason, bro. Like, why are you so motherfucking fast, bro? You know, reason for you to be that motherfucking fast, my nigga. God damn. Jesus. Spotlight in this room is locked, so I guess I can climb down these ladders. It's gonna bring me back over this way, but how do I get back inside the cinema? It's not okay. No, it's not gonna help. Okay, so it seems like the sign can allow me inside. So let me go back to that sign area. Let's see if I can find the spot where it will allow me inside, back inside. I do need to find the area for that key. So let me go back in here. Okay.
The scene had changed.
I don't remember if that's the name of the title that it was. I climbed up here, or how I even got up there, but I mean, we're gonna continue to investigate and try. Let's see. Yeah, it had to be that. Oh, this door right here, okay.
Was close to finding the solution.
This shit is aggravating as fuck.
is making progress.
Get out, bro.
Shadows congealing the darkness.
That shit was extra for no reason. I don't know why. I don't get it, but whatever. Let's do this part. This is the lobby.
Film that was a ritual, literally moving magic, and it created a period of time where there was still magic in the silver screen. Found myself in a maze of film equipment. There had to be a way to the projection booth from here. I was back where I started. A loop within a loop. I had to keep going. Story was losing it. I wasn't far behind.
Come on.
I was back at the beginning again. I had to keep going, find a way to the murder site.
Hello? Hey!
Show yourself! Who was it? Who said that? That's a real it's gone. Clever trick, asshole.
But I saw someone.
You can run, but you can't hide. The grand mask of my ass. You're a clown in a mask. I'm not the one wearing a mask here, you moron. Why don't you come here and say that to my face, buddy? Then we'll see who's the moron.
I was back at the beginning again. I had to keep going. Find a way to the murder site.
I'm here, you son of a bitch! Show yourself! Who was it? Shut up! That's a real
shut up! Shut up!
Fuck up!
Casey!
I'll get you! I'll get all you!
Look, you got the wrong guy! I'm not Alex Casey! I only play him in the movies! He's just a fictional character!
What's going on here?
You don't have to kill me. You don't have to go get that knife and stab me. You can just give up and go back. Forget about the ritual sacrifice to open the way forward.
The ritual sacrifice to open the way?
No. Oh, no. Oh, no, you don't. You'll be sorry.
Fuck.
Bro, what the hell is going on, bro?
Was getting close.
Welcome, Alex Casey. You've done well. You played your role perfectly.
Everything out of your mouth is a damn lie. The only place any of this makes any sense is in your psychotic brain.
Character in a story. You fulfilled your purpose. You brought the writer of the story.
What?
You can go now, Casey.
No, I'm not going anywhere before I get some answers. How was I in that movie? Why does all this feel so familiar? What? Who the fuck are you? Who the fuck am I? No!
And welcome to you, Alan Wake.
What the hell?
This the ritual to lead you on. We're just one step away from your final destination, Mr. Wake. But first, here's an unanswered mystery for you. If Casey was fictional, and you assumed his role as a detective, are you now fictional too? Whose story are you living, Mr. Wake?
The visions were getting under my skin, coming too close for comfort. Not a separate layer, but mingling with my own reality in the dark place.
Wait. Dead end. This can't be right. Did I miss something?
These niggas did a hell of a job, bro. Making this game. This game is
a murder site.
What?
The mask was the key.
Oh, this is. Is this the cops? This is the cops. This is how the cops, this is how they got taken. And then the mask is gone because Saga took
this
it.
This is how I could help her.
Saga Anderson, listen. I've been tricked. Scratch wrote returned. I tried to fix the story, but he stopped me before I reached the end. He has it now. It's the key to escape.
What do you mean, escape? Wait, Scratch.
I need to stop him. I need to stop him before he gets out. He's after Alice. I'm still trapped, but I'm making progress. I wrote you in to be the story's hero. Scratch made a horror story. I need to match the genre. It has to be dark, but the hero can break through, save her family, save us all.
Save her family? Are you talking about my family?
Yes. Whatever you're doing, it's working. You just need to keep going.
Did we have Van in the horror story?
I was closer now. Closer than ever before. But there was no time to lose. Everything was hanging in the balance. I could still lose it all. Parliament Tower. I had to make it work this time. I could stop Scratch, get the manuscript, fix its ending.
We're gonna continue. We're gonna go to... It's a Parliament Tower. Okay.
I was traveling deeper into the dark place. The poem on the wall was growing at the same pace, dogging my footsteps, like my unwanted shadow moving in the corner of my eye. It wasn't my writing. I didn't know what it was. A terrible prophecy, a curse looming over me.
Nightmare, but I damn well try.
This case would never be closed. I had more questions now than at the start. The irony of being trapped in a postmodern detective story. I felt watched. The eyes of some unseen audience on me. I wanted to turn to the hidden camera and tell them to fuck off. But I didn't know where to look to break the fourth wall. There would always be another case for Casey. A million stories in this dark city. The night opened up to welcome me. I walked into her arms. Roll credits.
Closed. No.
The building was condemned. Closed up. Something was wrong. Something was missing. I had to get inside. It wasn't Zane. It wasn't Scratch either.
Huh? You're me? Me? I don't understand. There's a lot I don't understand.
The dark place operates in loops. Time is a story. I'm calling you from a different point in that story.
From the future? I'm never getting out of here, am I?
Yes, you will. And no, you won't. And that is by your own choice.
What does that mean?
I'm sorry for what you'll have to go through. Alice's photos you found from the shoebox in the talk show basement. Before you can go to Parliament Tower, you must put them in the shoebox at her statue at the plaza to help you, to help Alice, to help Saga Anderson.
What?
I'm my own deus ex machina? Really?
In the shoebox? By the statue?
How many writers does it take to finish a story?
In a shoebox in the
one
plaza?
For each draft. It's the same writer, but in a different point in time. I follow the steps he laid out for me. Alice's photos in the talk show building basement. Adi had guided me there.
What's going on, bro? And this is where we're gonna end. Right here. So, everyone, I appreciate you. Anyway, everyone, I appreciate you for watching this video. I appreciate you for sticking around and joining this process and this commentary and everything. I know it's been fucking nuts because this shit is fucking nuts. This game is nuts. But yeah, man, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you go ahead, you leave. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you go ahead, you destroy that like button. Make sure you go ahead, you demolish that subscribe button. Make sure you go ahead and leave a comment about your favorite part of the video, about what you think is going to happen, your theories about Alan Wake in this game so far, and such on and so forth. Make sure you go ahead, you click that notification bell to be a part of the Big Bad Gang. And then also make sure you click that share button, share it to somebody who you love and care about. Share it to your mama, your brother, your sister. Your mama, your daddy, your brother, sister, your cousin, your grandpa, and your grandma. Because, you know, we out here trying to find us a nice, sexy, big, booty, thick, juicy sugar mama who's going to be out here paying our motherfucking bills. Okay? So please, please share it to your grandmama. Especially if you have a fine-ass grandmama. Okay? Hey man, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. And I will see y'all in the next video. Peace.